Hello students, today we will discuss about the various effects of current. As we are studying electricity, we have discussed that whenever there is a flow of charge, it constitutes a current. So whenever it flows or whenever we get current, there are many effects which are due to the presence of this current. These effects include chemical effect, magnetic effect, and heating effect of current. Let us first discuss about the heating effect of current. Its example is electric iron. As at our homes, we have noticed that whenever we want to iron our clothes, we just plug the electric iron into the switch and switch on the button or plug, and we see that after some period of time, the electric iron gets heated up. So this effect, this heating effect of the iron, shows that the current has the heating effect in it. So this was a domestic example which we can see in our daily life. Our next effect which we are going to discuss is chemical effect of current. In chemical effect of current, we come across a process known as electroplating. It is a process which is completely based on the reactivity of metals, and it is defined as the coating of metal on the surface of another metal based on their reactivity. Now, electroplating, we have discussed that it is a process of coating an element or coating a metal surface. Now there are various terminologies which are related to this process. So we will discuss those terminologies. Our first term to be discussed is, we know about, in chemistry we have seen cathode and anode. So those cathode and anode are also used in this process. So cathode, we know that it is the electrode which is connected to the negative terminal. While the electrode which is connected to the positive terminal is known as anode. In the last class, we have discussed about the symbols, and we have seen that in a cell of a battery, we have positive and negative terminals. So the wire or the electrode which is connected to the positive terminal is anode, while that which is connected to the negative terminal is known as cathode. Now let us discuss that what is electrode. Electrode is a piece of a metal or a metal wire through which the current enters or leaves. Means we have said that we are going to see the chemical effect. So there should be the presence of current. So the current, the path of the wire through which the current enters or leaves, the electrolyte. Now the term we come across is electrolyte. Basically, electrolyte is a chemical solution. Mainly, we consider it as a salt solution. So it is a salt solution or a chemical solution which conducts current. Means whenever there is a solution which carries the current or which have the conductivity in it is electrolyte. And whenever there is a conductivity of current or it conducts the current, there are some changes due to the presence of that current. So electrolyte is that solution which shows some effects due to the presence of current. But we said that it shows effect. So it is not like that every solution will be showing some effects. There are also some solutions which do not show any effect. So those solutions are known as non-electrolyte. In non-electrolyte, we can take example of vegetable oil or petrol. These are the two substances which do not show any effect on passing the current through them. But at the same time, if we take an example of any acid like HCl, H2SO4, they show the chemical effects. They show some effects or they show some changes in them. So these are the electrolytes. And the changes which are noticed in them or the phenomena which is noticed in them is known as electrolysis. So we are defining the electrode. So it is a metal wire which conducts. Our next term is ions. We know, we have studied atom. So we know that atom is electrically neutral because it has same number of electrons and same number of protons. Means number of electron is equal to number of protons. But there is sometimes gain or loss of electrons for stability. And due to this, gaining or losing of electrons make them charge. Hence, the atom or the group of atoms, we can say, which are charged are known as ions. So, we can define it as a charged species are known as ions. Again, we can take two types of these ions. Means, any atom, we said that it may gain or it may lose. Means, if it gains the electron, then the negative charge on it increases. Then negative charge on it increases. So, the atom or the ion which possesses the excess of negative charge or gains the electron is termed as anion. It is termed as anion. Why? Any atom which donates the electron or gives away the electron will be having excess of positive charge. So these positively charged species are known as cation. Now we said that these are the charged species. Due to their charge, these anions during the electrolysis process are discharged at anode being negatively charged, while cations being positively charged are discharged at cathode. So these are the two types of ions. Our next term is voltmeter. Voltmeter. It is the apparatus in which the whole process occurs. So, if we said that the process is occurring in it, so it contains the electrolyte and electrodes, that is cathode and anode, which are dipped in a solution known as electrolyte. So, this was the chemical effect of current, which can be visualized easily when we have any electrolyte solution. Now, apart from chemical and heating effect, current also have magnetic effect. So, we will discuss about magnetic effect of current. Magnetic effect of current can be easily visualized in electric bell. Its best example is electric bell which we use at our home. In magnetic effect of current, whenever current flows through a coil, It behaves like a magnet. And as soon as the current stops flowing through the coil, the magnetic effect which is present in that coil disappears. So the effect which is magnetic in the coil is temporary, that is only due to the presence of current. And this temporary effect of current makes the ringing of this electric bell. Now we will discuss about some dangers of electricity. If the current happens to pass through heart, means in our heart, if we want to pass the current, then it causes heart muscles to contract and death occurs. So by passing the electric current to the heart, we can make a person to be dead, because at that time all the muscles, that is cardiac muscles of the heart, will contract. All the electrical appliances in wet places are very dangerous, as we know that we should not touch the electric switches or electric conducts when we are wetted. So at wetted places, whenever they are used, they should be handled very carefully because they are very dangerous. Electricity could turn dangerous due to loose connections in switches and proper wiring. Means at our homes, if any wire is loosened or if any wire is hanging unnecessarily, it should be immediately repaired. And there should be no loose contacts at the electrical circuits. And they should be maintained, or they should be made to be treated regularly within a small interval of time. And last, there should be no overloading, means the electricity which we use at our homes should be properly used. There should be no wastage of electricity. Now there are some safety measures which should be used when using the electricity. The connections and plugs and switches must be made up of proper insulating material. Switches and plugs should never be touched with wet hands. All the appliances should be properly earthened so that they cannot give you the electric shocks. Whenever we want that the wiring should be insulated or the wiring to be checked, they should be checked while wearing rubber soled shoes, because rubber is a insulator. And defective and damaged plugs and sockets should be immediately replaced. We should not wait that it should make some accident and then we will repair it. There should not be such. They should be replaced as soon as possible. So this was the knowledge about the